Hello everyone and welcome to a new Elden Ring video. In today's video we're gonna do a quick comparison between the items that you can get from the Remembrance of the Morgoth. If you already defeated Morgoth, you're gonna get a Remembrance and you can choose between two items or you can get both of them. If you don't know how to get both of them, you have to go at a mausoleum on the map and to duplicate them, but be careful. There you'll have only 7 different mausoleums that you can duplicate your Remembrance. And yes, way more Remembrance than 7. Basically, you're gonna have to make some choices. Here I'm gonna show you what you're gonna get from the Morgoth Remembrance. The one that you are seeing right now, the Regal Omen Bairn, I hope I pronounce it right, this one with the spirits, is the first one. The second choice, it will be the sword, or depends. There is not a order that you can take those items. This is the sword that you can get from that Remembrance. And you have to, again, sometimes you'll have to choose, but you can also get them both. Something else, if you are in the New Game Plus, it's way much better, and way much easier. Because let's say you got from your first game one item, and if you are in the New Game Plus, you can get the second item. I am only here to show you both of them, but first things first, for beginners, let me show you how you can get these two beautiful items. I'm gonna explain so you know how to get them. From the first step, you have to go to Liurnia of the Lakes. We have to make our way to the capital, and at the end of the capital path, you're gonna find the boss, the main boss that it's in the capital at this moment. But how to get there? Go at the end of the lake to the north side, to the ravine, then go on a little hill on the right side to find Belum Church. From the Belum Church, you have to find the Grand Lift of Dectus. Then from the Grand Lift of Dectus, here at the Grand Lift of Dectus, you have to use the Dectus Medallion left and right. If you don't have that, I have a video on my channel with those items. Then make your way on the right, on the east part, go around the capital. You have to defeat a knight, and also you have to get in your inventory 2 great runes in order to enter to the capital. Now, right here you're gonna have that fight with the knight and enter to the capital rampart, make your way to the avenue balcony. That is in the middle of the capital, right over here, and then just keep going until you're gonna find the west capital rampart. Then you're gonna have a big fight with the Godfrey, the spirit of Godfrey, right here at the Earthry Sanctuary. And the next step is gonna be to go at the Queen Bedchamber, and right here you're gonna have the fight with Morgoth, from which you're gonna get the Remembrance. And if you don't know that guy, let me present you that. This is the Morgoth, the main boss that sittings at the base of the other, basically at the Elden Throne. And don't mistake this, if you are a beginner, this is not the end game boss. This is just a pretty powerful one, depends how good you are. Now, here I defeated Morgoth, and you're gonna get this item, the Great Rune from Morgoth, and also the Remembrance of the Omen King. Now it's time for me to show how you can duplicate that item, because yes, as a bonus, I want to show you that. I want this to be a complete video, but again, be very careful when you're gonna use that mausoleum, because are only 7 by one game. So if you are in the New Game Plus, another 7, obviously they will respawn and you can duplicate Remembrance. But I'm gonna assume that most of you are in the first game. Here at the 4th Church of Marika, you'll have to go on the map exactly on the field that I just showed you on the map. There is a big house that is just wandering around in that area. But if you want to find them all 7, because maybe you already used this one, I have a video on my channel with all 7 mausoleum location, a perfect video for you. Now, duplicate your Remembrance right over here from the Omen Lord or Omen King. I just did that. And now with that duplicated Remembrance, you have to go at the Table of the Lost Grace. Go at the old lady right over here and talk with her. And now you can buy both of the items. One is gonna be for free, and one we have to pay 5k runes. The Regal Omen Bairn, okay, and the Morgoth Cursed Sword. I'm gonna show you both of the items, and as a conclusion, at the end of this video, I'm gonna show which one I think it's the best. Because yes, I have a favorite. And in my first gameplay, I just took only the Regal Omen Bairn. I don't know why I did that. But that was my choice back then, and I didn't duplicate the Remembrance, and that's why I had a big decision to make. Which one do I want to take? This item that you are seeing right now basically is gonna release some spirits, some baby spirits, and those spirits gonna attack your target. You just have to set your target, but be careful because this has a pretty long lag in my opinion. When you try to cast it, as you can see, yeah, it will take you 2 or 3 seconds, so be careful, because if there is a fast target, you will have problem casting this. It's not a spell, it's not an incantation, I don't even know what it is, because you'll put this item exactly where you put your flask of health, exactly in that location, and you're gonna just use it. It's pretty fun, it's pretty powerful, and against big slow enemies, this thing in my opinion is just perfect. So it has some downsides, like the one that I just told you. The big downside is the lag time that you're gonna wait. And the second, probably, it's the fact that it's gonna consume you a lot of FP points when you use it. A lot of that. But as you can see, a big target like this, it can be done in few seconds, okay? If that guy don't want to kill me very fast. But yeah, a decent amount of damage. A decent amount of damages. Now I just... Okay. Some of those heads just hit this small guy. That's why it's still alive, my main guy. It has a pretty good range, but now it's time for me to show you a comparison. This is the sword. And this sword, in my opinion, and I'm not even joking, trust me when I tell you that, and this is my personal opinion, one of the best items in this game. It's so good, it looks amazing, it has a lot of damage. Everything for me, it's perfect about this sword. There is nothing that... Bro, look at this enemy. This is a very strong, aggressive enemy. And I will melt this enemy in seconds. And I'm not the best fighter. I don't know how to fight very well in this game. But this sword makes everything perfect. Again, I absolutely love the sword. And you know what? Let's cut the crap. I want to tell you from the start. This will be the best item that you can get from Morgoth. Not the other one. The other one is quite good, but if you want to have a really good sword with a perfect build, this is an end game sword, and definitely you can just finish the game with this item. Again, probably the best sword, one of the top three. You know what? I don't want to tell you that from now, because I have to take some other swords. I don't have all the weapons in this game, but I promise you that I will try to take them for you on my channel, on my YouTube channel. So stay with me, because daily I release videos with weapons, location, bosses, you name it. Thank you so much for watching. Like, subscribe, share, press that notification bell. I'm gonna see you in the next one. And yes, now you can become a member if you like by clicking the join button. And my choice for today, it will be this. Bye.